No matter how much I talk about sleep, sport, or calorie balance, the most popular questions I get are always about food and dieting. What's good, what's bad? So I decided to research this topic, structure my findings, and create a short video series dedicated solely to diets, to satisfy all of your burning questions. While researching modern diets, I realized that to get solid understanding of diets, we need to understand the history of human dietary changes. So let's start there. And many changes to our dietary habits started about 12,000 years ago. So we have a lot of ground to cover. Imagine you're living about 12,000 years ago, back when Mammy the Mammoth was still hanging around with Sid and Diego. You live in somewhere in what could have been Spain today and spend the night in your cave, sleeping on your bed of hard rocks. You wake up in the morning hungry. Never mind the pain in your neck from your rock pillow, you need to find food. But how? Where can you get your food? What are your options? Not many. There are no grocery stores or restaurants. There's fast food, but it's called fast only because it will probably be running away from you fast. Hunting animals and gathering plants or fruits are your only food options. That's it. This is basically how people got their food up until relatively recently, till 10,000 BC. Hunting animals and gathering plants or fruits. And the diet back then was different for different groups depending on many factors, like geographic location, climate, and specific ecologic niche. The Eskimo's diet, which was based solely on meat, was quite different from the diets of tribes living in tropical climate, who relied heavily on greens. But one thing was similar across the board. Their diets consisted of minimally processed wild animals and plant foods. Hi, Andre here. Welcome to the Practical Health Channel. Today and for the next several weeks, we'll talk about diets. We'll talk about the dietary changes for the last 12,000 years since the Paleolithic age, the history of dieting and the seven diet categories. Popular diets including paleo, vegetarian, vegan, keto, intermittent fasting, gluten-free, Atkins and others. Also, we'll try to figure out whether we're closer to herbivores or carnivores. We'll talk about the dietary habits of centenarians and whether we can learn something from them. And finally, we'll talk about the basics of diets. It's going to be an exciting several weeks. Okay, let's talk about changes of our dietary habits. About 12,000 years ago, our dietary habits started changing rapidly. But well before that, about 400,000 years ago, the first and the biggest game changer in how humans approach food was invented. The big bang of human nutrition. Fire. The ability to cook food or to pre-digest it. Fire allowed humans to eat energy-rich food without spending too many calories processing it. The first adaptation of human body through diet was done by the brain, the most important organ in our body, the master hub of our knowledge. The evolution of humanity rests on the duality of diet and brain evolution. And the major player in this evolution was meat. The basal energy consumption of human brain was gradually rose from about 8%, similar to what the apes have today, to about 20% of the total body's energy. This energy was easily provided by the absorbable denatured proteins and broken down lipids after heat cooking. Since the brain consumed more energy, its output became even more significant. New means to hunt, gather, and stock some of the leftover foods. Some people go even as far as making the statement, meat made us humans. The nutrients found in meat contribute not only to the brain, but also the entire metabolic system of the body and give us creatine, carnitine, taurine, iron, vitamin B12, vitamin D3, the components which boost the efficiency of the body. The second biggest change happened around 10,000 BC, when humans began to regularly exploit cereal grains. Contrary to popular belief, the first cereal grains were not Cheerios or mini wheats. They were actually emmer and anchor wheat. Now humans could shift profession from hunting and gathering towards farming. Humans could finally have a predictable and reliable source of food and could focus on evolving and developing in other areas, such as building housing, safely raising kids, and coming up with the new dance moves. This is when the world's population started growing fast. Over time, humans increased the variety of cultivated grains to include rice, barley, oats, and finally Cheerios. The grains have gradually become more and more widespread across the globe, just like K-pop today, Grain adoption significantly accelerated around the year of 1800, when the Industrial Revolution made mechanized steel roller mills and automated sifting devices available. By the way, 1800 was the same year the first battery was invented. Sounds like it was quite an innovative time. These devices helped significantly increase grain harvesting efficiency, but changed the nutritional characteristics of milled grain by removing the germ and bran in the milling process and leaving the flour comprised of mainly of endosperm of uniformly small particle size. Today, the share of grains in the typical Western diet is about 24%, and 85% of that is refined grains. The third major change in the human diet is the introduction of dairy products. It happened around 8000 BC and was driven by the domestication of goats and cows. The first evidence of dairy product is dated to about 4000 BC. I think it was pretty bold and innovative move for the first farmer to use milk from cow's udders. Today, milk and dairy products contribute about 11% to the typical Western diet. What was the impact of dairy products on health of humans? Quite significant. They not only increased the food diversity, but also provided nutrients such as calcium for the bones and proteins for the muscles. Next, in the same period with milk and dairy, refined vegetable oils appeared. The first evidence of a vegetable oil was olive oil, which dated back to 6000 BC. Since that, humanity started to produce oils from walnuts, almonds, sesame seeds, and flax seeds. Likely as early 3000-4000 BC. Actually, it's pretty hard to get specific about this when you talk about BC. Since then, vegetable oils have gained popularity across many cultures. And the growth of consumption of refined vegetable oils accelerated during, as you might guess, the Industrial Revolution, specifically with the mechanization of oilseed industry at around 1900. From 1900 to 2000, vegetable oils such as margarine, shortening, and cooking oils gained a good share in the typical Western diet, and it lends about 18% today. Since oils are nutrients densely packed with calories, exceeding the normal daily calorie threshold can happen far more frequent than needed. Another major shift in this period was the emergence of fatty domestic meats. Animal husbandry began with the domestication of animals like sheep, goats, and cows at around 8000 BC. Though a big shift started happening at around the year of 1850, when the industrial raising of cattle started. Industrial cattle raising, the practice of feeding grain to cattle sequestered in feedlots, made huge changes to the cattle growth process. In 1850, virtually all cattle were free-range or pasture-fed and were typically slaughtered at 4 to 5 years of age. By 1885, this time shrank to 24 months, and we got marbled meat. That excessive fat accumulation in muscles that adds a lot of flavor to the beef. This time span for the cattle raising went down further to just 14 months by 1950, with most cattle being classified as obese. This is how 99% of all cattle are raised today. This change from free-range to industrially raised cattle marked the shift from monounsaturated and polyunsaturated fatty acids to saturated fatty acids. Another big change is the introduction of salt. You might be surprised, but salt is a relatively recent dietary innovation. The earliest evidence of salt dates back to 6000 BC. Today, salt comes to our body with smoked, salted, or canned food, like meat, fish, or poultry, as well as salted nuts and other foods. Today, the typical Western diet includes about 10 grams of salt per day, and even more if you eat a lot of pretzels or pickles. Another period, which completely turned human nutrition upside down, happened when refined sugar came to play. The first evidence of refined sugar dates back to 500 BC, found in India. Though the massive adoption of refined sugar started during, again, the Industrial Revolution. Maybe it should be called the Industrial and Dietary Revolution. The consumption of refined sugar went up from about 6.8 kilograms per year in 1815 to about 69.1 kilograms in 2000. It's more than 10 times growth. And the significant change related to refined sugars happened around the year of 1970 with the introduction of high fructose corn syrup, or HFCS. Today, refined sugars contribute about 19% to the typical Western diet, and 42% of that is high fructose corn syrup. Finally, the last major addition to our diet was alcohol. Sweet, sweet booze. Alcohol is not a significant part of our calorie intake. It's only about 1.4%, but it's not a very new thing to our digestive system on an evolutionary scale. The first evidence of alcohol dates back to 5400 BC, but it's during the period between 800 and 1300 AD when alcohol became the intrinsic part of many cultures across the globe. As you can see, a lot of new food introductions happened for the last 12,000 years. If we sum up the percentage of these foods in the typical Western diet, we'll get about 71%. 71% of calories in the typical Western diet comes from the foods that did not exist about 12,000 years ago. Wow! A lot of things have changed since Adam ate his first apple, and things have definitely sped up for the last 200 years. So, if we analyze these developments, we can highlight 6 tectonic changes in our dietary habits. The first one is the beginning of food processing by heating. It happened around 400,000 years ago. And 5 other changes happened in the last 12,000 years. Diversification of foods by raising cattle, processing milk, processing oils, and using salt in cooking. The rise of refined sugars and alcohol, 2 of the most pleasure-inducing components in our diet. A shift in micronutrient composition from protein to carbs. The timing. The Industrial Revolution gave us basically 24-hour-a-day access to food. Finally, 71% of calories we consume today comes from the foods that didn't exist 12,000 years ago, which is a pretty drastic and fast change on the evolutionary scale. There is a growing evidence that the profound changes in the human diet that began about 400,000 years ago happened way too fast on the evolution time scale for our digestive system to adapt. When we talk about diets, you'll see that many diets try to reverse one or more of those changes. So in the next video, we'll talk about the health ramification of these dietary changes and the 7 diet categories. See you next week. Bye.